Hello students, today we are going to do a practical related to the study of water holding capacity of soil, different types of soil sample. For this we have collected three different soil samples, and here we have sample A, sample B and sample C, and this is your electronic balance in which we are going to measure the different soil samples 5 grams. Okay, so at first we have to set it into zero, so you can see that it is set zero. So first we have to put a petri dish, so again we have to make it into zero, and then with the help of this spatula we will collect 5 grams of this soil. Okay, so it has almost become to 5 grams of this sample A. Now let us take another petri dish for the next sample. So at first again we have to set it, okay, and then we will collect the next soil sample, sample B, and put it into this petri dish, that same 5 grams. Okay, so this is also 5 grams, so this is second sample. And now the third sample, again let us adjust it, and this is the third sample, again 5 grams we have to collect, so this is also 5 grams. Now we will do the next step after this measuring. Now that we have collected the three samples 5 grams each, now what we will be doing is that these samples we will be putting it in this funnel in which I have already made this paper cup using the filter paper, and this is a measuring cylinder, all the three. Now I will be pouring it into this paper funnel, sample A first, okay, and here is your sample B. And this one is your sample C. Okay, after this, this is a measuring cylinder. You can see here the markings have been made. So this is 10 ml measuring cylinder. I will be collecting 10 ml water and pouring it into these three funnels. Okay, so this is 10 ml water which has been taken in this measuring cylinder. Now I will be pouring it into this sample A soil. In the other samples also I will be pouring 10 ml of water, okay, and I will be waiting for 5 minutes, so that drop by drop you can see the water is falling into the container. Okay, so drop by drop from all the three samples water is getting collected at the bottom of the container. Now this is sample A, this is sample B, and this is sample C. Now here you can see already so much of water has been collected, isn't it? And here also moderate water is getting collected, water is coming drop by drop, and here you can see the rate of water coming is very low, it has just started falling, you can see the drops. So the rate of water falling in the three containers, you can see that how slowly it is falling in the last sample. Now we will be waiting for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes then we will again measure how much water is collected in it, so that we can understand what is the maximum water holding capacity of which soil, and accordingly we will be able to know that which is the best soil for water holding, and which is moderate, and which is the least water holding soil. Next, what we have to do is that we have to check the pH of these three types of soil with the help of this pH paper. So we will be collecting three pH paper for three different samples, and now what you have to do is that in this wet soil only you have to just dip this pH paper, and you have to dry it for some time. Okay, so this is the pH paper in the first sample, and this is the pH paper which has been dipped in the second sample. Okay, and this one is the pH paper which has been dipped into the third sample. Now by keeping this three pH papers in the different, this is in my hand, this is first sample, this is second sample, sample B, and this is the third sample. Okay, we have to wait it so that it gets little bit dry, and then this is a pH meter, pH scale is here, and we can see with the help of this pH meter that which type of soil is alkaline, which soil is slightly alkaline, and which is, you know, acidic or like that. We will be comparing it. Okay, so let us wait for some time. You can see that now these three pH papers have somewhat dried. Now if you just try to match it with this pH meter, you can find that this pH is almost like that of 6. Okay, that is between 5 and 6. Okay, this sample A. Now about this sample B, that also you can see that it is somewhat slightly between 5 and that of this 3 here. Okay, 5 and 3, so you can take it to be that of your somewhat even yes, 5.5 or like that. Okay, and this one, this sample number C, which is the last soil here, you can see that this sample is also having somewhat pH related to that of 5. Okay, so this is the three type of pH which we have recorded today. That is this one to be your 6, this one to be your 5.5, or and this one is your 5. And now by this time you can see that the water has collected. Now what we are going to do next is that we will be removing this funnel, okay, and we will pour this water into the measuring cylinder. And here you can see that the water which is collected, that is almost 5 ml. So 10 ml water was given and 5 ml water has been collected after 5 minutes. Okay, so this is the first sample, that is 5 ml water has been collected. And now let us see what happens in the second sample. In the second sample, the water collected, let us pour it into this measuring cylinder. So here you can see that the water collected is almost 3.2, okay, 3.2 or 3.3, 3.2, okay, 3.2 is the water being collected in this sample. And the last sample, water which has been collected is your 2 ml, you can see here. So these are the three that is separate type of soil which is holding water differently. The first one you can see that it was more, the middle one it was medium, and this one is the least one. So this one actually was somewhat sandy, so the particles were more or large in size, so the water holding capacity is less. And here it was having a mixture of sandy soil and that of the clay soil, so that is why it was moderate water was collected here, and it was very fine particles, clay soil, so the water collected here is only 2 ml. So it proves that the more finer the particles of the soil are, lesser will be the water collected and more will be the water holding capacity. So the clay soil can hold more water compared to that of the sandy soil and loamy soil. And loamy soil, since it is a mixture of both sandy soil and clay soil, so it will be holding moderate amount of water. And sandy soil, since the particle size is maximum, so it cannot hold water for as a result, and the water percolates down very easily and fastly. So water holding capacity is minimum in case of your sandy soil. Okay, now we will be doing the calculation of this practical. This is the observation table of the practical which we are doing, that is the water holding capacity, in which the first thing you have to write is serial number. Then is soil sample, which is 5 grams for sample A, sample B and sample C. Then volume of water added is 10 ml, okay, and the amount of water collected is your respectively 5 ml for sample A, 3.2 ml for that is sample B, and for sample C it is 2 ml. The next thing which we are going to calculate is water retain. Now this water retain, how we will be calculating is that we will be subtracting from 10 ml this 5 ml. So for the first sample, sample A, it will be your 5 ml. So water retained will be your 5 ml. For the second sample, that is your sample B, from 10 ml if you subtract 3.2, it will be becoming your 6.8 ml. Okay, and finally for the sample C, if you subtract 2 ml from 10, it will become your 8 ml of water which is retained within the soil. Now pH of the three samples have been given as 6, 5.5 and 5. You can note down this, and this is how you're going to write it in the copy regarding the observation table, the format. Okay, so that was today's practical, that is water holding capacity of the different soil samples and its calculation. I hope you have understood how to do this practical well. Thank you.